welcome to Portugal, we welcome to Lisbon, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen. Let me start welcoming you and thanking the organization for inviting me to open this 27th edition of the European Biomass Conference and Exhibition, and for having chosen our country to hold this important event. In doing so, you have elected our country as the capital of the climate sector for 2019, on par with other major events such as the African Energy Forum, Energy Business Forum for the Union for Mediterranean, and many others. It's a great honor to open this major event, a leading platform for the biomass specialists that combines one of the largest sciences and technologies conferences with a high-quality industry exhibition, attracting biomass professionals from around the globe to our country. Portugal has been a front-runner promoting renewable energy, and we remain committed to maintaining that status. The integration of renewables in electricity generation raised 26 percentage points since 2005, reaching more than 50% since 2014. Last year, in March, we generated more renewable electricity than we consumed. In 2018, wind power generation had a 23% share in electricity generation, and this year, on the 1st of February, wind generation reached a 63% share, supporting 90% of national consumption. Portugal is currently the seventh country in the European Union with the highest penetration of renewables in electricity. Renewable electricity generation have played a key role in the decarbonization of the economy, contributing to a 17% emission reduction since 2005. And all of this only have been possible because Portugal is a country with a large potential regarding renewable energy resources, and because we have assumed in a very clear way the commitment to energy transition. In 2016, and in line with the ambition of the Paris Agreement, the Portuguese government outlined its chosen routes and the commitment to reach a carbon neutral economy by 2050 by developing a carbon neutrality roadmap towards 2050 and a national energy and climate plan for 2030. In doing so, our country wants to give an unmitigated sign that is committed to maintaining its stance on the forefront of those that are tackling the extraordinary challenges that will confront the climate sector for the foreseeable future. We were the first country in the world to commit ourselves to be carbon neutral by 2050. The roadmap translates the vision, sets the path, and provides the most cost-effective options to achieve a neutral balance between emissions and carbon sequestration by 2050. And our ambition for 2030 through our energy and climate plan is to set new emission reduction targets up to 55% when compared to 2005. 35% target for energy efficiency, 47% for renewable energy in gross final energy demand, and achieving 80% renewable sources in electricity generation. This is an ambitious but realistic plan. These targets are a natural sequence to our previous achievements and are aligned with our future challenges. Ladies and gentlemen, soon we will approve a resolution in the Council of Ministers establishing the strategy for biomass in our country. This resolution will be adapted to this new vision and favoring proximity to the resource and consumers of thermal energy and making more efficient and sustainable use of biomass. But why are we doing this? First, because we have renewable targets to achieve, and biomass represents one of the ways to achieve them. And according to our National Plan for Energy and Climate, we want to do it in the most efficient and sustainable way. Second, because the forestry sector in Portugal occupies a preeminent place in the national economy, and it is estimated to contribute almost 3 billion euros to the trade balance, representing a generation of wealth corresponding to around 2% of national GDP and 8% of industrial GDP. Third, because this industrial sector is well consolidated and is responsible for a very significant volume of exports with a very high incorporation of national added value. Fourth, because the safeguarding of this forest heritage has a very important impact in defending jobs in rural areas and in rural livelihoods, helping to secure population through new forest-related activities, improving their relationship with rural areas, and, in this way, developing great respect for the preservation of their sustainability and diversity. Biomass use is also a crucial way to prevent forest fires, a critical task for the present and for a future which will make our country even more vulnerable to these types of events. To be carbon neutral by 2050, we have to reduce the area that burns every year on rural fires for half of the figures that we have today. It is therefore a national imperative to support biomass energy production resulting from forest cleanup. Following a request from the Portuguese government, the European Commission approved on 8th of January of 2018, under the EU rules on state aid, a scheme to support biomass facilities located close to forested areas considered as critical in terms of fire risk. We know, and the European Commission also knows, that the potential of forestry and agriculture in the supply of biomass is far from exhausted, on the contrary. The study commissioned by the European Commission for PricewaterhouseCoopers called Sustainable and Optimal Use of Biomass for Energy in the EU Beyond 2020 estimates that this contribution could triple in some scenarios. In the 2030 horizon, even though not all quantified biomass can be mobilized, both physically and economically. So, in view of the importance of the forest and the forestry sector in the national economy, one of the solutions to be implemented will be the promotion and support for the installation of decentralized cogeneration powers units of variable size and dimensionized according to heating and cooling needs, which do not push us more pressure on terms of availability of biomass and in the energy system, and that are better suited for to forest management. Why not to maintain the current model focused on biomass dedicated to electricity production only? Because the mode for the valorization of biomass using thermoelectric plants for the exclusive production of electricity has a very low efficiency, which forces find a guaranteed rate positively discriminated to monetize the associated investment. We believe that only solutions that guarantee the energy efficiency of the projects through the full use of the thermal energy produced must merit support to the electricity sales tariff and the need for full valorization of the thermal energy produced allows to guarantee the sustainable and efficient design of the projects that are presented. In order to support implementation of concept demonstration solutions for small biomass decentralized thermal power plants that do not push as much pressure on biomass availability and on the energy system as better suited to forest management. A specific notice is available under the Operational Program for Sustainable and Efficiency in Use of Resources, which are the money coming from the Cohesion Fund. The amounts foreseen in this notice amounts to more than 20 million euros. To this value is added the amount available to support the tariff of sale of electricity of 21 million euros for 15 years. The total amount of funding available to support installation of this type of power stations amounts to 340 million euros. Nonetheless, the benefits of continuous effective forest clearance will be much greater than the costs of supporting small power plant networks that organically burn this type of biomass, allowing downstream to save money spent on firefighting, in addition to the lost patrimonial wealth of difficult accounting, if we include, for example, biodiversity, soil erosion and greenhouse gas emissions. Ladies and gentlemen, the world of energy is changing quickly. It is imperative that the right choices are made in the shift to a carbon neutral economy, ensuring affordable, secure and sustainable energy for business and households. In these transformative times, we require a coherent investment strategy which will take full benefit of the most effective and efficient means that may contribute to the reduction of our energy dependency, promote social well-being, strengthen economic competitiveness, encourage scientific innovation, foster environmental protection, and mitigate the effects of climate change. Portugal believes that addressing climate change challenges and promoting the transition towards a low-carbon society will allow us to be more prosperous, to create more jobs, to have a fair society well within the limits imposed by our nation.